What is up, guys? So before I start this review, I have to give a shout out to my sponsor, Bespoke Post. Now, they are a monthly membership subscription club, and each month you get about $70 worth of stuff. It's pretty cool. You can find things from new products, new emerging brands, and you get anything from home lifestyle stuff. You can get outdoor gear, you can get pretty much anything to help you step up your life in some sort of way. And once again, if you like to discover those new brands, this is a cool way to do it. I do have a promo code FOREST20, so I'm going to link that right here at the bottom of the screen. You guys can use that. I'll also have their link in the description, but I'm going to go ahead and unbox this and see what's in here. All right, so this subscription box is about $45 a month, but once again, you get about $70 worth of stuff, and it's all pretty cool stuff, so I'm gonna see what I have in here. All right, so here's some of the stuff I got in here. I got some pain relievers, basically for like hangovers and things like that. I've got some camping lights right here. I have some energy bars. I've got this nice duffel bag, which I can literally smell the leather, which smells amazing, so you can tell it's like some really high quality stuff. So really like that. Over here, looks like I got some. Ooh, I got a candle which smells amazing. Jeez, it smells really good. And the cool part about this is you can definitely be as flexible as you need to with the subscription. So if you can cancel anytime, you can pretty much have it set up any way you'd like. And whenever you go to the website, as soon as you scroll all the way down, there is a quiz that's gonna have you take. So be sure to take that, and that's how they know what products to send you, because they basically tailor it to what you like specifically. So that way every month you know you're getting things that you would like, and you can actually preview what you have coming. That way you can see more of that as well. All right, once again, guys, be sure to use my code FOREST20. You get 20% off of your purchase for a Bespoke box. And once again, you get so much stuff in here. It's very, very cool. And don't forget that quiz, because that's what's gonna make sure you get the things that you want. But even if you don't, you can send things back and really make it exactly what you want it to be. What is up, guys? So today is a very exciting day. I'm reviewing my dream car. I've loved this car ever since I realized it was even a thing in Europe. And if you've read the title, you already pretty much know what it is. So right behind me today, I have the Audi RS6 Avant. And this is the first time a performance Audi wagon has come to the United States to take on the likes of the Mercedes-Benz E63S station wagon. So we're gonna review this thing in full detail, and despite you thinking I may have a bias towards it, I'm actually gonna be slightly harder on this car because I have such high expectations for it. Now, let's go ahead and jump in and see how good this RS6 is. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and check out the Audi RS6 Avant. And if you don't already know, this is available in the United States. So excited to see these things driving around. This does compete with things like the Mercedes-Benz E63S AMG station wagon. And I'm just gonna go ahead and throw it out there. That car is going to be faster than this. Faster in a straight line. It's just a monster. This is a monster as well. It's just not going to be quite as fast as a Mercedes. Now, if you don't like Mercedes and what they offer, you prefer Audi, now you have the choice of getting the Audi over the Mercedes-Benz if that's more your flavor. There's the starting price on the screen. This one as is going to be about $117,000 as equipped. Now, this is missing a few options. It's missing the upgraded wheels. You can get like these machined wheels. It's missing the carbon ceramic brakes. It's missing the sports exhaust. It's missing the black optic package as well. So, fully loaded, you can expect this to be about $130,000, maybe $140,000, and that's not including some dealerships charging over. That's eye-watering, but arguably you get an extremely rare and just a really cool sought-after car
in the enthusiast community. Now, coming to this color, this is a really cool black because it shows a ton of the pearl effect in it. So you guys can see a closer up B-roll clip of it here. It looks great in the sunlight. And I will say with all the silver accenting, I do like it on this black colored car because it really highlights those silver accents. You can see them a little bit clearer if you got something like a red or a blue. So I think this is a really good combo. I quite like it. Wouldn't personally be something I would choose, but I can see why someone would like this spec right here. It looks very nice. Now coming to the front, you're going to have this huge grille basically to feed that twin turbocharged V8 all that nice cool air, depending on where you live. And if you come down here, you're going to have these open areas to feed your intercoolers, obviously your radiator, things like that. Now once again, this silver slat here, this silver slat under here, those can be blacked out with the black optic as well as your Audi rings. Now unfortunately, these three slats under the hood are going to be fake. They don't do anything. They don't go anywhere. So do wish those were actually functional in the RS, but it's not a massive deal to me personally. Now coming to the lights, you have full LED lights. It has LED daytime running lights, which look great during the day. Now at night, when you unlock the car, it is going to have an animation that shows up. Very cool. Basically everything slams to the middle. Let's go ahead and move to these wheels because they are insane, as well as what's sitting behind the wheels. So these are 22-inch wheels, absolutely massive. They fill up that wheel well, very well. They are silver. You can get the machined finish. I like the design. I just don't like the silver color, and I'll get to that in just a second. Now behind there, you have 16.5-inch brakes. Once again, standard brakes. If you go to the carbon ceramics, that brings you up to 17.3 inches, which is humongous. I've seen cars that don't even have wheels that big. So the fact that the brakes are that big is just insane. And obviously you have six piston calipers to stop you pretty well. 285 tires, Pirelli P0s all the way around, nice square setup because you have all wheel drive. And the negative about having these massive brakes and having silver wheels is you get this beautiful brake dust going all around your wheels right here. So that doesn't look too great, and easily one of the reasons I would go with blacked out wheels over the silver wheels. And if you like to keep your car clean, this is going to be a nightmare. So I would just suggest not to go with light colored wheels. Down here, you are going to have the silver accent, the signature silver accent or satin silver going around your mirror cap, and then a chrome accent going around your window. And then you have your roof rails up here, which are silver. Once again, all that can be blacked out with the black optics package. And you can really see how much these fender flares stick out. It looks amazing. It almost looks like a wide body kit from the factory. For an Audi, it looks amazing. And one of my favorite views is if you look at the front just right, you can see the tire poking out just a little bit. And man, it looks so aggressive. Now moving back to the side profile, love it because the wagon has a unique look. It looks classy, but then at the same time, when you get closer to it, you can appreciate all those more aggressive cues, aggressive details, and you can tell there's something more serious about this car. And those two things combined really create a unique looking vehicle that definitely has caught a lot of attention in just the 48 hours that I've had it. Now, as you move to the rear quarter panel, you can see that shoulder line start to make itself more prominent right here. The back end just looks really good overall. I think Audi did a great job with basically to the passenger door back. It has an aggressive look, it looks sporty, yet it's still functional like a station wagon should be. LED tail lights in the rear, same animation, though I like this animation better. Slaps to the middle, and then right at the top, you have this really cool Tron-like effect that happens really quickly. RS6 badge right there. I'm not a fan of this almost bent paperclip look back here. If you go black optic, it will fix that. But personally, I don't like it. And you know, it looks in the eye of the beholder, so I'm not gonna hold that against the car. And then these exhaust tips can be blacked out with the sports exhaust. And let's go ahead and fire up the standard exhaust, hear how the twin turbo V8 sounds. All right, you guys, so here's your key for the RS6 Avant. Now, it is gonna say RS on the back, which is nice. That way everyone knows you have an RS car. You can place it face up on your dinner table and everyone can know you're driving the best of the best. But it's a very solid key, pretty much the same key design you get on other new Audis. You've got your lock, you can have your unlock, tap this twice to open the hatch, your Audi rings right there, panic button on the back, and then a physical latch here to release a key to get in if this battery dies or if the battery on your RS6 were to die, you can still get in, get your belongings, do what you need to do. So this does have obviously the key to get in, and then you also have touch sensitive areas on the door handle. So you have this slightly indented area here. I just rest my thumb there. That's going to lock it. You have this nice beep that's gonna let you know that it's locked. There's a touchpad behind here. I just put my hand there. That's going to unlock it. So very simple. And this also is going to have soft closed doors. So if you don't wanna slam your door shut, all you have to do is just barely close it. Shuts the rest of the way for you. Pretty nice. Now, getting into the RS6, let's see how that is. Now, one thing that's pretty interesting is this basically side sill right here is actually pretty thick. So it sticks out pretty far. So you may have to like watch your ankle or your shin whenever you're getting in. But other than that, getting in is pretty easy. I'm 6 feet tall and boom, no issues there. Didn't have to worry about hitting my head. It's not too low. It's great. Now, door materials on here are awesome. So you have this leather here with some stitching. Right below that, you have what looks like carbon fiber, but it's like this like aluminum feel. It's very cool. Your door handle is perfectly flush with the design. Soft plastics here, metal here, two memory seat settings, window controls, this saddle brown leather, which is just really soft and plush, feels great. And then this is actually going to be like a softer plastic. So if I do that, it's not going to be as loud as like hard, gross plastic. And then right down here, you have your trunk release, your Bang & Olufsen speaker, which is going to have a light that is going to illuminate at night, looks very good. And then you have your RS6 branded door sill. This is also going to illuminate at night, looks awesome, just adds that nice feature whenever you approach your car at night, it looks amazing. And then you have your seating controls, which are pretty basic. Now, this has the sport seats, which means you don't get the massage setting. You will have to go to like the comfort seats to get massage seats and things like that. So you either want sporty seats or you want comfortable seats that aren't necessarily as supportive or cool looking. So that is unfortunate that Audi makes you choose between the two. I love the massage seats, so I feel like I would personally go with that and just take the hit. But if you really love these quilted RS badge seats, they're very cool and they make the car just feel and look even sportier. So the controls right here are basically pretty simple. Now, in terms of the pedals, aluminum pedals here with your nice rubber grips right there, they feel super solid. Your dead pedal is like literally brushed aluminum and it looks awesome. You've got this nice cubby here, which is pretty deep. I mean, look at this. You can fit this whole thing in here. You can fit a novel in there and just read it in some spare time if you're like in a long drive through. I don't know. But it's pretty cool and it's damped in felt, or it's lined in felt. That way the sound is dampened out and you're not gonna hear things jiggling or rattling around, which is pretty nice. Now, let's go ahead and start this thing up and check out the inside. Okay, so shutting the door on the RS6. Nice solid shut, silent. Obviously you have nice sound deadening here. You have double pane windows. So the windows are thick and it really helps insulate a lot of that sound inside of the cabin and keep everything outside. Now to start, very simple, foot in the brake. As long as you have the key on the inside, you're gonna hit this really cool engine start stop button. It's got this red outline with the black in the middle. And there we go. Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about this steering wheel. Very nice design. One knock already is I wish it was a flat bottom. I'm surprised it's not a flat bottom. I mean, this is an RS car. And then to the right, you have voice commands, phone commands, previous, next, volume, your RS mode, which I'll get to in just a second. And over here to the left is how you control your virtual cockpit, which is gonna be right here in the middle, which I will also get to in just a second. Now, you have these paddles back here, which are different for the RS models. They've got this really nice aluminum feel to it, and they're actually see-through. So I don't know if you guys can see this, but I can actually see like right through here, and it looks pretty neat. So obviously your plus and your minus, they feel pretty solid. And then your wipers, cruise control, blinkers, things like that. Now, coming back to the virtual cockpit, if you guys have not seen this, this is Audi's virtual cockpit. It's very simplistic despite it looking pretty complicated. So if I hit this view button on the steering wheel, it'll change my view. I can go through different things by using these arrows. So I can see things like G meters, my boost, my oil temp. I can scroll over and see like what's playing. If you want music, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, which this also has. telephone, the map information, which is super high definition. I can zoom all the way in, I can zoom all the way out and see all of the coast of SoCal right here, which is pretty awesome. And if I hit view again, it'll change that menu, give me the signature, like thicker hockey puck style rev counter, which is specific to the RS. And then you always have this power and torque gauge over here to the right. And then I can also hit this menu button, go through and do things like sport displays, lap times. This can actually measure your 0 to 60, but we actually have a drag here, which is a more reliable version of 0 to 60. And we're gonna test out what this can do later. But it is nice to know that it does include that in here, but it's kind of hard to trust these things, especially when the manufacturer puts it in. It may say it does 0 to 60 a little bit quicker than it actually does. So it's always good to have stuff like this. So that's pretty much it for that. As you come up, leather here, you have a head-up display, which looks amazing. You guys probably can't see it from there. So there's a B-roll clip, very vivid, very detailed. And whenever you switch into your RS mode, it is going to give you that same rev counter on your head-up display, and it looks very cool. Now, Bang & Olufsen speakers, so this basically the entire 75% of this dash is going to be speaker, and the sound system is amazing. It sounds incredible. As you come down, you have more of that like aluminum texture here, nice gloss black. The interior illumination here is amazing. It looks great, and I can actually go through the screen, adjust my colors. I can pick two different colors if I want to as well, and you know, that's kind of stuff you would expect on this type of car. Now, one thing that is specific to the RS is this RS monitor. So if I click this here, I can go through, see things like my oil temp, I can see my coolant, I can see brake rotors, transmission fluid, the differential, and it gives me this gauge here to show me if it's cold, warm, hot, or if it's overheated. And if I scroll over, I have all my G meters right here, and then I have tire pressure, which is obviously only available above 16 miles per hour. Other than that, it's pretty standard Audi MMI. If you guys have never seen this, go back and watch some of my other Audi reviews. It's pretty much the exact same. Actually, it is the exact same as all of that. Driver assistance features, seat features, and then just all of your media and things like that. Then as you go down, this is all of your climate control. So I can control my climate here by just pushing this plus and minus, or I can scroll over, go up and down, and adjust it that way. Fan speed, different zones, heated and cooled seats for both driver and passenger, three settings, obviously. Then as you go down, you have your drive select, and that's where I can actually go in and basically customize my RS1 and RS2 modes. So let's go ahead and get into that real quick. So if I hit, let's say RS1, I can have that as my aggressive mode, have everything in its most sporty setting. And then my RS2 is basically everything in the sporty setting except for like suspension and the differential, and then ESC is on. So it is nice that you can hit this button here and it'll switch you between those two modes. So if I hit that there, that'll throw me into RS1, if you guys can see that there. And if I hit it again, that'll throw me into RS2. Hit it one more time, full automatic mode, where it'll basically throw itself into different modes depending on how you're driving. Now, other than that, you've got all your camera views here. So if I hit this camera button, you have my 360 view, very, very high res camera, your 3D view, which is awesome. And I can actually use this to scroll around the car, which is pretty cool. And it's hilarious because I'm pretty sure this RS6 has cooler wheels than are on this RS6. So I thought that was hilarious. Maybe that'll get the owners to upgrade or something, I don't know, but it's pretty cool. But I wish it would actually match it to the color of your car. I just feel like that'd be a nice detail that owners would love to see. But other than that, moving back, you've got your shifter, leather, aluminum, pull back for drive, all the way forward for reverse. We've already talked about the backup camera. Push this to throw it into park. More of that crazy texture coming here. Obviously your cup holders, aluminum parking brake. And then as you come back, you have your armrests. If you lift that up, you have a wireless charging pad and two USB-Cs. So if you're not up to date on your tech and you don't have a USB-C, get some, because this does not have USB. So if you have a typical USB, you cannot plug it in anywhere in this car, USB-C only. And then it's pretty shallow storage space. It's actually not very usable if you have bigger items. All right, as you move up, you have your frameless mirror right here, touch sensitive lights, your buttons here to operate the moonroof and the shades on top of that, which we'll show you more of in the back seat. And then you're going to have your vanity mirror with an LED light, and it is going to extend. So that's pretty nice. It's gonna wrap up the inside, at least the front. Let's go ahead and check out the back seat. All right, guys, so the back seat of the RS6 is actually a pretty good place to be. So I'm 6 feet tall. This is where I was sat, and I've got a good amount of room. I actually have almost 3 inches of knee room because you have these super deep cutouts right here, which is nice. Now, obviously, you have your mat pockets, which are pretty standard things nowadays. My feet room is pretty good if you can see it over this massive transmission tunnel hump. This is huge. If you plan to put a third person here, they're literally going to be horseback riding because this is so tall. It's pretty insane. One of the tallest ones I've seen. That is a downside about the back seat. Now, once again, feet room is great. Headroom is excellent. I probably have better headroom in here than I do in like an Audi Q8 or even an Audi Q7. So I'm 6 feet tall, but my hair is also another like 2 to 3 inches above me. And I have another 2 to 3 inches above that. You can easily be like 6'3 to 6'5 and fit back here. I'm not sure how your leg room will be, but your headroom should be fine. And a lot of that is due to this double moonroof up here. It just gives you so much extra space. And it's very nice to have on top of just giving you a nice, beautiful view of the cabin. Now, one thing I do like are these touch sensitive areas down here. So you have heated seats for both outboard passengers, 3 different settings. It's got some nice haptic feedback touch to it. Your temperature, fan speed, different zones, things like that. 2 more USB-Cs, a 12 volt. And then as we come to the seats, you've got these nice bolsters for the outboard passengers, which is nice because it kind of holds you in place. If you're sitting in the middle, you've got this hard plastic piece which is going to probably be digging in your back and it's not going to feel too good. But if you do fold this down, you've got a nice armrest under here, very shallow, but you've got some carpeting in there. And you have the Audi cup holders, which I am just not a fan of. I just think it's a weird design. You can fit bottled drinks in here, no problem, but don't plan on putting anything in there that doesn't have a closed lid or closed top, because it just doesn't feel very secure in here. So that's just a small nitpick thing, to be honest. Now, other than that, let's talk about the door. So one of my favorite things is as you come to the back, you have the same materials, which is nice. So leather, tan leather, Alcantara, this nice metal right here. You are going to have your sunscreen shades for both doors, which is nice. But even cooler than that, and this is a small detail, but I really appreciate it. Down here, this isn't gonna be hard plastic. This has a little bit of give to it, and if I scratch it, it's not gonna make this hard, gross noise. So I'm very impressed to see that. And the storage space down here is actually very, very good. Now, when you shut the door, solid shut as always. And then right here on this pillar, you are going to have a vent as well, and 2 more vents in the middle. So that's pretty much gonna wrap up the back seat. Let's go ahead and check out trunk space. All right, so coming to the back of the RS6 Avant. Now, being a station wagon, it has its obvious benefits. And the number one obvious benefit is the amount of room you have back here. Now, station wagons are so popular, especially among car enthusiasts, because they offer you the practicality of an SUV without having the rollover risk, without having the higher center of gravity. You get a better just overall stance and feel with the car. And cargo capacity is excellent. I mean, this is about as big as you would find in something like the Audi Q8, for example. And you can get a lot more space because if you fold those seats down, obviously you're going to have just a lot more room to put things. Now, you do have this cargo cover back here, and the cool thing about this cargo cover is that it's actually electronic. So whenever you shut this, it's going to close automatically by itself, which is nice because usually I'll have to pull this closed, push it back open, and it just does all that for you, and it's awesome. Now, to fold the seats down, there's 2 ways. You can use the triggers located on the seats themselves, or you have these little handles here, and I just pull that. As you guys can see, the seats are going to fold down very easily, just like that. And now, if you guys can see here as well, you've got these really bright LED lights, which is great because when you're trying to do things at night, you can see everything, you can get what you need to get out of here, into here, and it just makes it a lot easier. Now, here you are going to have this aluminum piece, and it's pretty sturdy. So this can take all the beatings, all the hits, if you load in, let's say, a box washing machine or like a lawnmower or something like that, which those are pretty big items, and you will be able to fit them in the back of your RS6 Avant, which is awesome. Now, if I lift up the floor, you're not gonna have much. You literally have this shallow area that I can probably put like a notepad. I'm not really sure what else you would put there, but it is nice to have that. And you do have this nice little railing system here that you can utilize if you choose to do that as well. But that's pretty much gonna wrap up the back. Here is the exact cubic feet, if you guys need to know that. Let's go ahead and shut this and see what powers this thing. All right, you guys, the first thing we're gonna do is a launch control. And to launch it, it's very easy. Hold traction. It's gonna say stability control in sport, and then it's gonna say ESC off. I just leave it in S1, foot all the way down on the brake, floor the accelerator, let it build up boost, and then let go. Oh! Jeez, this thing is a monster. So I'm gonna pull over just a second. The craziest part about the launch is it's just, I mean, first of all, it's insane seeing a wagon or an estate, whatever you want to call it, going that quickly from a stop. It's just insane to witness it. The fastest one I've been able to get is like 3.41, I think is what it was, I'm not too sure. But I actually did that launch at night when everything was a lot cooler. It was about low 60s here in Orange County area. And I just so happened to have my camera with me. I was filming a bunch of shots. So here's that shot of my 3.4 second 0 to 60. Okay, now that we've done 0 to 60, let's go ahead and just drive this RS6 and see what it's like. Now, first, let's talk about what this is and what it is not. It is a very luxurious, practical, fast, and comfortable, remember that word, station wagon that is very unique. It's something that's pretty rare, and I haven't had a ton of people look at this, but the very few people who did look at this, they instantly knew what it was and they just geeked out on it. So if you like attention, but you don't like just constant attention, like if you're in like a supercar or you don't always want people racing you all the time, you don't get that in this, which could be good or bad. If you like the attention, like hardcore like the attention, then you won't like it. But if you're okay with really, really flying under the radar, yet having the capability to, you know, surpass most people on the road, this is a good option. It sounds great. Is it as fast as like an E63S station wagon? No. Is it as fast as an M5? No. It still has a very strong hit. It feels great. This is plenty of power for anyone, really. The thing is that it just doesn't hit as hard as those other two cars. So if you're okay with that and you're willing to sacrifice a little bit of straight line performance for arguably easier to use tech, an arguably better looking vehicle, then it's totally up to you. And if you're an Audi fan, this is a great way to go. Personally, I think this is my favorite. I'm just a huge fan of the Audi wagons. I love the design of it. I think everything that it has works very well together. The power is enough for me. And then if you're really serious about more power, you can always tune this thing. And we all know that Audis tuned are just a force to be reckoned with. Now you can tune the other brands as well, but if you want this car, you don't like the looks of the other cars, that's another option for you as well. Now let's go ahead and get into performance. So this has your paddle shifters, and let's go ahead and use the paddles. We're in first gear. Super quick, and it sounds amazing. Oh my gosh, this isn't even the sports exhaust, and it has such a like low frequency growl and just gurgle to it. And when you downshift, listen. Not the loudest pops, it's more of like these deep gurgles, and it sounds really good. You can quiet things up by switching it out of RS mode, which I have been in this whole time. So here's auto mode. And then when I accelerate, ooh, it still sounds pretty good. It doesn't completely take away your sound, but you do have to really get on it to get it to come alive, if you will. But it does well. Does it handle pretty well? Well, not quite. It handles okay. It's a big station wagon. I mean, the level of, I guess, rawness that most people expect from an RS is actually too much. It's not as aggressive as you guys would think. Even though it's an RS model, it's not as hardcore as you may assume with it being the top performance variant. It's actually very daily drivable. And back to that word comfort that I mentioned earlier, this is extremely comfortable. I've driven almost 500 miles, about 200 of which were spent from Laguna Niguel to Santa Monica, or I'm sorry, Malibu, and then back. Very, very comfortable. So comfortable. We can easily cross country this car.
It's not quite something you can say about the M5. It's comfortable-ish, but the suspension is a little bit rougher. Same with the E63S. This transmission is also butter. It is way smoother than the BMW, especially when you're shifting manually. The BMW likes to jerk you a lot. I get it's great for just feeling more engaged with the car, but I actually am not a big fan of it. It feels a little bit sloppy, and it just doesn't seem like something that will be good for the transmission long term. This still gives you those fast shifts, but they're smooth, seamless. You don't have a power cut, and it just keeps on going. It's great.
Well, everyone, that's going to wrap up my review of the Audi RS6 Avant. This is a great vehicle. Once again, if you like the idea of the E63S station wagon, you don't like the looks of Mercedes, you don't like the tech of Mercedes, if you're willing to give up just a little bit of that extra straight line speed, the Audi is a solid way to go. Once again, if you're serious about more power, you can always tune this thing just like you can with pretty much any gasoline powered vehicle. Let me know what you guys think, comment below. And if you're new to my channel, I'd love to have you guys subscribe. Be sure to hit the bell, that way you guys never miss an upload. I'll see you guys in the next one. Y'all take care. Bye.